हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट खिलजी डायनेस्टी एंड तुगलक डायनेस्टी। खिलजी डायनेस्टी रूल फ्रॉम 1290 टू 1320 एंड खिलजी वेयर ऑफ मिक्सड ओरिजिन। दे वेयर ऑफ टर्कीज एंड अफगान ओरिजिन, मिक्सड ओरिजिन। दे वेयर पोस्टेड ऑन वेस्टर्न फ्रंट टू डिफेंड द टेरिटरी फ्रॉम मंगोल अटैक्स ड्यूरिंग द रेन ऑफ स्लेव डायनेस्टी। And when the slave dynasty was ruled by weak rulers, Jalaluddin Khilji took the advantage and captured the throne. He ascended the throne at the age of 17 and ruled for a short span of time of 6 years, from 1290 to 1296. And after becoming Sultan, he appointed Alauddin Khilji as Amir-e-Tujuk. Amir-e-Tujuk was post of Master of Ceremonies. Jalaluddin Khilji, he ruled from 1290 to 1296. He was supported by non-Turkish officers, as during slave dynasty, higher positions were offered to Turkish only. And Khiljis were of mixed origin, Turko-Afghan origin, so they were supported by non-Turkish officers. Rise of the Khilji dynasty ended the monopoly of Turkish in higher post. He was a liberal ruler, and as per his view, governance should be based on people who were getting governed. And as he was ruling Hindu majority state, he did not claim his rule as Islamic state. And he did not punish anyone harshly. Even the robbers and rebel group were left with strong warning only. Because of his generosity, many nobles considered him as weak ruler and felt no fear in opposing the Sultan. In 1291, a revolt happened in Kara region, which was suppressed by Alauddin Khilji. And after this, Alauddin Khilji was appointed as governor of Kara or Awadh region. In 1293, when Alauddin Khilji raided Bhilsa is territory in Malwa region, and it was Parmara territory. And after raiding the Bhilsa, Alauddin Khilji gifted the looted treasury to Jalaluddin Khilji. And Jalaluddin Khilji made Alauddin Khilji as Arij-e Mamlik or Minister of War. Alauddin Khilji, he ruled from 1296 to 1316. He was the nephew and son-in-law of Jalaluddin Khilji. He killed Jalaluddin Khilji to become the next Sultan. And before becoming Sultan, he was the governor of Awadh and he was governor of army. In 1296, he looted Devgir in Deccan and returned with a great treasury at Kara. When Jalaluddin came to get the share of the Sultan from the looted treasury, he was killed by Alauddin Khilji. And after this, Alauddin Khilji marched to Delhi with a big army. Jalaluddin's wife and younger son took shelter in Multan region. And at that time, Multan region was governed by one of the son of Jalaluddin Khilji. In the same year, 1296, he sent an army led by Uluk Khan. Uluk Khan was brother of Alauddin Khilji and Jafar Khan to capture the Multan region. And after capturing the Multan region, the blood relatives of Jalaluddin Khilji were persecuted. And after the conquest of Multan, he appointed Nusrat Khan as his wazir. Nusrat Khan was his brother-in-law. So there were four trustworthy persons of Alauddin Khilji. One is Uluk Khan, who was brother of Alauddin Khilji, then Jafar Khan. And after that, Nusrat Khan. Nusrat Khan was brother-in-law, and then fourth one is Malik Kafur. Initially, after killing the Sultan, he granted a lot of money to nobles in order to get their support. But later, after making a stronghold, he confiscated the property of nobles, and those who tried to revolt against Alauddin Khilji were punished harshly, and even their family members get punished for their act. And this was described by Burney. He built Siri Fort at Delhi to defend the seat of Delhi. He successfully defended the territory from Mongol. At that time, the Mongol Empire was divided into many small empires that was ruled by the son of the successor of Genghis Khan or son of Genghis Khan. Jafar Khan died while defending territory from Mongol in 1299. So one of his trustworthy person died while defending territory from Mongol in 1299. In 306, after victory over Mongol, his army raided the Mongol territory. Once Mongol used to raid Indian territory, but in 1306, Alauddin Khilji's army raided the Mongol territory. To restrict the rising power of nobles, he issued guidelines. The first one is nobles were forbidden to hold festivities, and to discourage festive parties by others, he banned wine and intoxicants. He also banned prostitution. And no marriage alliance between nobles without the permission of Sultan. So there was marriage alliance system between nobles to make their position stronghold, so that one noble support other noble because of matrimonial and alliance. So to stop this, he put restriction that no marriage alliance will happen between nobles without the permission of Sultan. And he also deployed spy system to monitor the nobles. Because of harsh punishment and strong monitoring, hardly any rebellion took place in his reign. And nobles became afraid to raise any voice against the Sultan, even during the reign of later Khilji rulers. He converted all charity land into Khalsa land or government land. Even some of the Ekta land was converted into Khalsa land by Alauddin Khilji. Regarding administrative reforms of Alauddin Khilji, he abolished small ikta and increased kharaj. Kharaj was agriculture tax. He increased kharaj to one half of agriculture produce, and he also eliminated the intermediaries by direct collection of kharaj from cultivators. And for that purpose, he established a department named Must Kharaj. He was the first Sultan to order measurement of land for tax collection. He added two new texts that were non-Islamic in nature. One is Gharai. Gharai was a house tax. Then Charai. Charai was pastoral tax. So these two texts were non-Islamic in nature. The Islamic tax in Islamic religion were jizya, zakat, kharaj, khamas, and other tax. We will see when we will learn about administration of Delhi Sultanate. Regarding army reforms, he was the first Sultan of Delhi to maintain a standing army, and soldiers were paid in cash. He started maintaining a database of soldiers by introducing Hulia and Dak system. Hulia was description of soldiers, and Dak system was branding of army horse. He maintained a large army by paying less salaries, and to improve the standard of living of standing army within the given salary, small amount of salary, he introduced four markets in Delhi region. First is grain market, then second market was clothes, sugar, dry fruit and oil market, third was for horse, slave and cattle market, and fourth one was for miscellaneous items, and each market was headed by Sanai Mandi, and he deployed munians. Munians were small children and they worked as a spies. They used to monitor corrupt practice in corrupt practices in the market. And if anyone was found guilty, he gets severe punishment. So Alauddin Khilji made army reform. He made a standing army, a large standing army with paying a small salary. And to make their life sustainable, he stabilized four market in Delhi region, and he controlled the price of commodity in these four market, so that the soldiers were able to buy items of their need in their small amount of salary. But these reforms, the market reform was probably around Delhi region only, because there are no traces that he made the same market reform in other cities of Khilji territory. He made the Sultan share in war loot. War loot was khamas. Khamas was tax. Khamas, war loot tax. He made the Sultan share in khamas as 4/5. Initially it was 1/5, but it was Alauddin Khilji who made who declared that the Sultan share will be 4/5 of the looted treasury. Cultural contribution. He patronized Amir Khusro and Amir Hasan Sijji or Hasan Dahlavi. Amir is the title of commander. It is title given by Muslim ruler, so it was not name. Name was Khusro and Hasan. So Amir Khusro and Amir Hasan were patronized by Alauddin Khilji, and both of them were disciples of Nizamuddin Aulia. Amir Hasan wrote Fawad al-Fuad, and Fawad al-Fuad is teaching of Nizamuddin Aulia. Amir Hasan was known by his pen name Saadi-e-Hind. So there was another name of Amir Hasan, and he was also known by this name, and this name is Saadi-e-Hind. Alauddin Khilji was the first sultan to separate religion and state affairs or political affairs. As per Burney, the 14th century historian, Alauddin once thought to establish a new religion by considering himself as the next prophet. But Alauddin was convinced by Burney's uncle not to do so, as it will create rebellion among people. Later historian discarded the claim of Burney about establishing a new religion by Alauddin. Alauddin built Alai Darwaja, a gateway to Qutub Minar. He also started construction of Alai Minar, having double in size as compared to Qutub Minar. But he died before completing the construction of Alai Minar. So Alai Minar is still unfinished, and Alauddin Khilji built Hauj Khas Lake and new capital at Siri Fort. So here was the territory that Alauddin Khilji got from Jalaluddin Khilji. So the political map is northern region was controlled by Khilji dynasty. Then in southern India, there was Yadava dynasty ruling in Maharashtra region, Kakatiya dynasty ruling in Andhra Pradesh region, and then Hoysala dynasty ruling in Karnataka region. And after becoming Sultan, Alauddin Khilji raided Gujarat region first. And after raiding Gujarat region, the coastal city of India, because coastal territory of India, he raided Ranthambore. Ranthambore was a region in Rajasthan. And after conquering Gujarat and Ranthambore, he tried to capture Chittor region. So his third expedition was against Chittor. And after that, he made expedition for Malwa territory. And after these four, after northern India expedition, he started southern India expedition. In southern India, the first expedition was against Yadava or Devgir region. And after that, he made attempt to capture Kakatiya territory and then Hoysala region. So we will see the expedition of Alauddin Khilji. Alauddin Khilji expeditions. So in 1299 he made expedition to Gujarat region, and it was first expedition of Alauddin Khilji after becoming Sultan. And under the leadership, this expedition was under the leadership of Uluk Khan and Nusrat Khan against King Karna. At that time, the Gujarat region was governed by King Karna. And in this expedition, Munich slave Malik Kafur was brought to Delhi. Malik Kafur is also known by another name, Hajar Dinari. And the kingdom, the Gujarat region get annexed in 1304. And his second expedition was for Ranthambore in 1301. And this expedition was led by Uluk Khan and Nusrat Khan. Nusrat Khan got killed in this battle, and after his death, Alauddin took charge of the battle. Finally, Hamir Dev, the ruler of Ranthambore, the Chauhan ruler of Ranthambore, also got killed in this battle. Then his third expedition was against Chittor. Amir Khusro came to Chittor with Alauddin Khilji, and one section of army was on a raid to Warangal region, ruled by Kakatiya dynasty. At the same time, Delhi was attacked by Mongol. Although Alauddin Khilji reached Delhi before Mongol, but Delhi was raided by Mongol. Regarding Chittor expedition, a book was written by Malik Muhammad Jaisi, 16th century historian, and the name of the book was Padmavati. It describes the Chittor expedition of Alauddin Khilji and about Queen Padmavati, who committed Johar after the fall of Chittor kingdom. Then his next expedition was against Malwa region in 1305. And it was the territory of Parmara kingdom. In the same year, Mongol attacked India, and as per Farista, 16th century historian, 8,000 heads or sir of Mongol were used to build Siri fort. And after this, he made many expeditions in northern territory. And after north expedition, he started expedition in south region under the leadership of Malik Kafur. And he did not annex southern territory except Devgir. In 1306, he sent an expedition under the leadership of Malik Kafur against Devgir. And at that time, Devgir was ruled by Yadava dynasty, and the ruler was King Ramdev. Ramdev was defeated in the battle and accepted the suzerainty of Delhi Sultanate. But later in 1330, the kingdom was annexed and Malik Kafur became the governor of Devgir. So it was the only southern kingdom that was annexed by Alauddin Khilji. And rest were made the subordinate of Delhi Sultanate. Next expedition was against Warangal in 1308. The Warangal region was ruled by Kakatiya dynasty, and the ruler was Rudra Dev. And after getting defeated, after the defeat of Rudra Dev, the Rudra Dev accepted the overlordship of Khilji dynasty or Alauddin Khilji. And from Warangal expedition, Malik Kafur returned with Kohinoor diamond, and Kohinoor was taken to Delhi region. Next expedition was Dwar Samudram or Karnataka in 1310. एंड दिस रीजन वॉज रूल्ड बाई होयसला डायनेस्टी एंड द रूलर वॉज भल्लाल थ्री. आफ्टर दैट ही मेड एक्सपेडिशन अगेंस्ट मदुरई किंगडम इन 1311 एंड मदुरई वॉज रूल्ड बाई पांड्या डायनेस्टी. अलाउद्दीन खिलजी एम टू विन द वर्ल्ड लाइक सिकंदर डिड एंड ही टुक द टाइटल ऑफ सिकंदर सानी और सेकेंड सिकंदर. सो दिस वॉज द मैप ऑफ खिलजी डायनेस्टी आफ्टर अलाउद्दीन खिलजी मेड द साउदर्न एंड नॉर्दर्न एक्सपेडिशन. सो ही स्टार्ट कंट्रोलिंग मोस्ट ऑफ द इंडियन टेरिटरी not directly but as by their vassals as most of the southern kingdom accepted overlordship of Delhi Sultanate. Death of Alauddin Khilji. After his death, his favorite slave Malik Kafur raised a minor son of Alauddin Khilji to the throne. Malik Kafur tried to imprison or blind all other sons of Alauddin Khilji. And when he tried to blind Alauddin's sons Mubarak Shah, Mubarak Shah killed Malik Kafur with the help of Royal King's Guard, who had served Alauddin in the past. Later, Mubarak Shah blinded his younger brother to become king. The younger brother who was made Sultan by Malik Kafur. After ascending the throne, Mubarak Shah gave the title of Khusro Khan to a Hindu slave. And later, Khusro Khan killed the Mubarak Shah and ascended the throne. And no one dared to raise voice against next Sultan Khusro Khan. And even Sufi saint Nizamuddin Aulia accepted Khusro Khan as next Sultan, as Nobel lost their voice against Sultan after getting harshly punished during the reign of Alauddin Khilji. So they don't even try to revolt against Khusro Khan, who was originally a Hindu who later get converted into Muslim or Islam. Later, Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq rebelled against Khusro, and to get support of other nobles, he used converted Muslim issue to dethrone Khusro. And in 1320, Khusro got killed, and the Tughlaq dynasty was established over Delhi region or Delhi Sultanate. Amir Khusro was patronized by Alauddin Khilji, and he was Persian Sufi singer and spiritual disciple of Nizamuddin Aulia. During the slave dynasty, he served as a soldier, and over time he became famous for his poetry. He was given the title of Amir by Jalaluddin Khilji. Later he became court poet of Alauddin Khilji. He wrote poetry in Persian and Urdu language, Urdu or Hindavi language, and Urdu was originated from Khadi Boli or Hindi, and he was known as Parrot of India or Tuti e Hind. He was considered as father of Urdu literature and Qawwali. He created a new literature style in Persia known as Sabak e Hindi. He introduced Ghazal in India. Ghazal originated in Arabia in 7th century AD, but it was introduced in India by Amir Khusro. His first poetry work was Tawfat-us-Sigar. The Tawfat-us-Sigar means the gift of childhood. He wrote his first poetry at the age of 16 to 18 year old. He wrote poetry in praise of slave dynasty, Khilji dynasty and Tughlaq dynasty. He wrote Miftah-ul-Futuh, and it was key to victories, and it was in praise of Jalaluddin Khilji. Then Amir Khusro wrote Khazana-ul-Futuh, and it was the treasury of victory, and it was in praise of Alauddin Khilji. He also wrote Khamas e Khusro. Khamas means five, a collection of five. So Khamas e Khusro means collection of five by Khusro, by Amir Khusro. So in these five collection we found some important big books like Laila Majnu and Aine Sikandari. His next compilation was Tughlaqnama. Tughlaqnama was related to Tughlaq dynasty, and there was a phrase which says that if there is a paradise, then it was in Kashmir region. So it was probably given by Amir Khusro, and it was read as Agar Firdaus Bar Ruye Jami Ast Hami Asto Hami Asto Hami Asto. Amir Khusro buried next to his spiritual leader Nizamuddin Aulia in Delhi. Next is Tughlaq dynasty. Tughlaq dynasty ruled from 1320 to 1414. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was governor of Punjab region. He established the Tughlaq dynasty after killing the Khusro Khan, a converted Muslim. And this Tughlaq dynasty was of Turkish origin. The three important ruler of this dynasty was Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, Muhammad bin Tughlaq and Firoz Shah Tughlaq. The dynasty was at its zenith from 1330 to 1335 under Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He controlled most of the Indian subcontinent. The dynasty was known for brutality, torture and harsh methods, and this finally led to disintegration of empire. In 1336, a new kingdom emerged named Vijayanagar in the Karnataka region. Later in 1347, Bahmani kingdom became the first independent Muslim kingdom of the Deccan, and was founded by declaring independence from Tughlaq dynasty. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq or Ghazi Malik. He ruled from 1320 to 1325. And his father was a Turkish slave and mother was an Indian. He brought Bengal, Utkal or Orissa and Warangal under his control. He fortified the defense of northwestern frontier to counter Mongol invasion. He established the city of Tughlaqabad and started the construction of Tughlaqabad Fort. He sent his son Uluq Khan to raid Devgir region in 1321, but Uluq Khan failed in the first attempt, but Uluq Khan succeeded in the second attempt. In 1323, the Kakatiya Empire, ruled by Pratap Rudra Deva II, was annexed by Tughlaq Empire under the leadership of Uluq Khan. As in Khilji dynasty, the Kakatiya Empire was under the Delhi Sultanate, but after the end of Khilji dynasty, Kakatiya stopped paying tribute to Delhi Sultanate. So it was annexed during the reign of Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq and under the leadership of Uluq Khan or Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq put down Ghiyasuddin Bahadur's rebellion in Bengal region. In 1325, while returning from Bengal, Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq died as a result of the collapse of wooden pavilion built by Uluq Khan or Muhammad bin Tughlaq. And he built this pavilion for celebrating Bengal victory by his father Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq or Ghazi Malik. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq had not good terms with Nizamuddin Aulia, and he planned to punish Nizamuddin Aulia on returning Delhi from Bengal expedition. And at that time Nizamuddin Aulia said Hanuj Delhi Durast, and it means Delhi is still far away. that you are trying to punish me and you are still far away from Delhi. And he died before reaching the Delhi. According to some historian, he died as a result of plot hatched by his son Uluk Khan or Muhammad bin Tughlaq, because the pavilion was built by him and he employed royal architect Mir Imam Ahmad to build pavilion. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq lowered the tax rate on Muslim that was prevalent during Khilji dynasty, but he raised the tax on Hindus, and it was described by historian Ziauddin Birni. The next Sultan of Tughlaq dynasty was Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He ruled from 1325 to 1351 AD. Succeeded Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq and took the name of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He was the most educated Sultan and he made 3 experiments during his reign. And because of the failure of these experiments, a modern phrase became popular, and it was Tughlaqi Farman. His first experiment was shifting to second capital at Daulatabad or Devgir from Delhi in 1327 to 1329 AD. At the time of Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, Muhammad bin Tughlaq was the governor of Devgir, and in initial year of his reign, he made Daulatabad as his second capital for better control of southern territory. He ordered nobles, Sufi saint, and other royal workers to shift to Daulatabad, and Daulatabad was 1,500 km away from Delhi. He ordered the shifting of people from Delhi to Daulatabad in summer season, and because of this many travelers died. And later, when revolt started happening in the northern territory, he shifted back to Delhi after 2 years. But with this shift, he made a road connecting Delhi with Daulatabad with a lot of resting houses along the road. This led to more connection between North India and South India. And also, after shift to Daulatabad, many Sufi saints settled down in Daulatabad and did not return to Delhi after 2 years. So a cultural mixing of Islamic and Hindu tradition in Deccan region happened, and this was the reason for rise of Bahmani kingdom or first Muslim rule in Deccan region. As per Birni and Ibn Battuta, he shifted to Daulatabad with all population of Delhi, but this was discarded by other modern historians as coins were found of this period from Delhi region. His second experiment was introduction of token currency in 1330 AD. In modern times, the same metal is used for all values of coins: 1 rupees coin, 2 rupees coin, 5 rupees coin or 10 rupees coin. So we use same metal, but we describe it is 1 rupees coin or 2 rupees coin or 10 rupees coin, and it is part of token currency. But during medieval times, the value of coins were decided by its weight and metal type, whether it is silver, gold or copper metal, and what is the weight of metal. During the reign of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, when there is scarcity of silver, he introduced that token currency by replacing silver tanka with bronze coins. He made silver coins equal to bronze coin, but he failed to control forgery. Many people start making bronze coin at their house. So lot of fake bronze coin came into market, and because of fakeness, in the end Muhammad bin Tughlaq was forced to replace bronze coin in the market with silver coins. And because of replacing large forged coins, the royal treasury got affected. His third experiment was start of agriculture department or loan system. With the failure of 2 experiments and impeding the royal treasury, He increased tax to deal with the economy of the state. He increased land tax 10 to 15 times from Hindu subjects, and he also increased kharj tax or agriculture produce as one half of the agriculture produce. He also raised jizya. This led to the giving up of agriculture practice by many peasants, and people start living in forest or become robbers. Muhammad bin Tughlaq ordered to capture runaway peasant and punish them harshly. And to minimize the burden of high taxes on farmer because of running away by peasant and other practice like revolt, like chances of revolt, to minimize all these side effect and burden of high tax on farmers, he introduced a new department for agriculture loan, and this department was known as Diwane Kohi, and they used to give loan to farmer, and this loan was Takkavi loan or Sondhar loan. But this department failed to fulfill its aim, as it was administered by inexperienced and corrupt administrators who used to divert funds for their personal purpose and started recording false accounts. In 1327, Muhammad bin Tughlaq built fort city of Delhi, and it was named Jahanpana. It was built enclosing the then inhabited area between Kila Raya Pithoda and Siri. He tried to lead an expedition to Tibet, but was defeated midway by the ruler of Kangra. This, along with other reason, led to drop out the plan of attacking Persia and establishing Sunni Islam there. So he had planned to attack Persia region and establishing Sunni Islam there. At that time there was Shia Islam in Persia region. But after getting defeated in Tibet expedition, he dropped the plan of attacking Persia region. Ibn Battuta. Ibn Battuta was a Moroccan traveler. He visited India during the reign of Muhammad bin Tughlaq in 1333. Ibn Battuta was appointed as the chief Qazi of Delhi. He wrote his travelogue named Rihla. And another important court person of Muhammad bin Tughlaq was Ziauddin Barni. Ziauddin Barni was the court historian of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and during the reign of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, the disintegration of empire began. In 1336, Vijayanagar kingdom emerged in South India, and after that, in 1347, Bahmani kingdom emerged in Deccan region, and it was first Muslim kingdom in Deccan region. Toghan Timur, a Mongol ruler, asked permission from Muhammad bin Tughlaq to repair the Buddhist monastery at Himalaya. In 1347, the Sultan granted permission and dispatched Ibn Battuta to the court of Toghan Timur, the Chinese emperor, or Tibetan emperor, not Chinese emperor, Tibetan emperor. And at that time, Ibn Battuta, Muhammad bin Tughlaq lost confidence in Ibn Battuta, so he sent him to the court of Toghan Timur, and the convoy got looted in midway, and somehow Ibn Battuta managed to reach Gujarat region, and from Gujarat region Ibn Battuta reached Calicut, which was ruled by Jamorin ruler. Ibn Battuta was afraid to return Delhi, so he left India from South India region, as there was a clash between Ibn Battuta and Muhammad bin Tughlaq in later time. So he was afraid to return to Delhi, and he left India from South India region. After the death of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, he was succeeded by Mahmud ibn Muhammad, who was replaced by Firoz Shah Tughlaq after a month of his reign. So For a short span of time, 1 month, there was another king, Mahmud ibn Muhammad, but after, he ruled only for 1 month, and after that, Firoz Shah Tughlaq succeeded. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was described as a mixture of opposite sultan by contemporary historians, but later historian discarded this view. Badoni was court person of Akbar, and Badoni commented on the death of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He gave the statement that the king was freed from his people and they from their king. So he made experiment which hurted the citizens, like increasing the tax rate, shifting the capital from Delhi to Daulatabad in summer time. So they were forced to walk 1500 kilometer. Then introduction of token currency, which hurted trading community or traders. So people were not happy with the experiment of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. And Tughlaq was also not happy with the people, as they start opposing the Sultan because of his experiment. So Badoni gave the statement that the king was freed from his people and they from their king. Here the they means people. Tughlaq is a Kannad book written by Girish Karnad, and it described the reign of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and now the book is used for play. So here is the territory that was initially controlled by Muhammad bin Tughlaq, but during his reign the disintegration of empire started, and in southern India Vijayanagar Empire emerged, then Bahmani emerged, and even in North India Bengal declared its independence, and we found Bengal Sultanate. So the territorial extent was very small as compared to earlier year of reign. Next ruler was Firoz Shah Tughlaq. He ruled from 1351 to 1388. He was cousin of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and he was liberal in punishment. In Tughlaq dynasty, the punishment was very severe, and there was a culture of torture. So the punishment and torture were liberalized by Firoz Shah Tughlaq. But Firoz Shah Tughlaq executed Shia and Hindu scholars. Unlike his cousin who worked on agriculture loan aspect only, he worked on the development of canals and irrigation system, and he was the first Delhi Sultan to work on the canal system. He is regarded as the father of irrigation or canal system in India, and he was first Sultan to impose irrigation tax, as he worked on irrigation or canal system, so he imposed irrigation tax also. So he was first Sultan to do so. He established two new departments, Diwane Bandagani, and it was for slave, and second department was Diwane Khairat for charity. He wrote his autobiography Futuhat-e-Firozshahi. He was supporter of scholar Ziauddin Barni, and Barni wrote Tarikh-e-Firozshahi. Tarikh-e-Firozshahi described the time period from Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq to first 6 years of Firoz Shah Tughlaq reign. Barni also wrote Fatwa Jahandari, and Fatwa Jahandari is describing the hierarchy among Muslim communities or succession rule, how the next sultan should be selected. So it was like political book, something like political book. Firoz Shah Tughlaq imposed jizya on Brahmins also. Earlier Brahmins were exempted from jizya, but Firoz Shah Tughlaq was the first ruler who imposed jizya on Brahmins also. Exemption from taxes and jizya for those who convert to Islam, and by lavishing new converts with present and honors, he made इस्लामाइजेशन ऑफ लार्ज पॉपुलेशन. ही रिव्यूड द इक्ता सिस्टम एंड मेड इट हेरिडिटरी. इक्ता सिस्टम वॉज ऑन सेटबैक बिकॉज ऑफ अलाउद्दीन खिलजी who annexed a small ikta, but ikta system was revived by Firoz Shah Tughlaq and he made the ikta system hereditary. He established a new town called Firozabad, which was the fifth city of Delhi and which is now known as Firoz Shah Kotla. He repaired the Qutub Minar, which was struck by lightning. He brought two Ashokan pillar, Topada Ambala and Merat pillar, and erected them in Firozabad. Regarding city development in Delhi, in 1008 AD, Lal Kot was founded by Angpal II. Angpal II was Tomar ruler and it was the first city. After that, in 1303, Sri was founded by Alauddin Khilji. Then in 1321, Tughlaqabad was founded by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. Then in 1327, Jahanpanah founded by Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and in 1354, Firozabad was established. The decline of Tughlaq dynasty. Firoz Shah did not make any attempt to expand the territory, but rather lost many regions to independent kingdoms. His eldest son, Fateh Khan, died in 1376, and Firoz Shah then decided to make his other son, Prince Muhammad, as next king. But in novel revolted against this and asked Firoz Shah to make his grandson Tughlaq Khan as next sultan. Firoz Shah died in 1388 and was buried in Hoj Khas, and civil war was started during the end period of the reign of Firoz Shah Tughlaq, and this weakened the Sultanate. Tughlaq Khan, which was not blood relative of Tughlaq dynasty, assumed power, but he died in conflict. So after Firoz Shah Tughlaq, the Tughlaq dynasty was ruled by non-Tughlaq ruler. In Tughlaq Khan assumed power but died in conflict. In 1389, Abu Bakr Shah assumed power, but he too died within a year. The civil war continued under Sultan Muhammad Shah. The Sultanate started disintegrating with numerous rebellions and smaller Hindu and Muslim kingdoms asserting their independence. And two sultans emerged during the end period of Tughlaq dynasty. One was Mahmud Khan at Delhi, and the second sultan was Nusrat Shah at Firozabad. So there was many smaller kingdom, and even the Delhi Sultanate was ruled by two different sultan. One was Muhammad Khan, who was ruling from Delhi, and another one was Nusrat Shah, who was ruling from Firozabad. In 1398, the Turko-Mongol invader Timur the Lamb or Tamerlane invaded and defeated the army of Delhi Sultanate, and he looted Delhi for more than 1 month. And Timur the Lamb or Tamerlane was the first ruler of Timurid dynasty. Timur's invasion and destruction of Delhi, subsequent rebellion and massacre of citizens created chaos, and the city did not recover from this loss for almost a century. Timur appointed Khizr Khan, the founder of the succeeding Sayyid dynasty, as his viceroy at Delhi. Initially, Khizr Khan could only establish his control over Multan, Dipalpur and parts of Sindh. But soon he started his campaign against Delhi Sultanate and entered Delhi victoriously in 1414. The year 1414 marked the end of Tughlaq dynasty rule in India. This is the end of lecture. Thank you.